The lineup was complete in the late window when Sturm Graz, Union Saint-Gilloise, Olympiakos and Molde made it through and won their second leg matches. The stakes now, of course, are even higher, higher than ever, as we inch closer to Athens, the site of this year's final. Let's take a closer look at this year's final 16 clubs. Everybody wants to get to Athens, right? So much excitement already, more to come in the next round. I now like to invite on stage the man who will be overseeing the proceedings, UEFA Deputy General Secretary, Giorgio Marchetti. Welcome, Giorgio.
Thank you, Pedro.
Over to you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. The knockout round playoffs took us on a stirring journey as more than half of the ties was decided by just one goal, showcasing how dynamic, competitive and unpredictable this competition is. Congratulations to the 8 winners on a well-deserved place in today's draw, who must now face one of the group winners. Although the UEFA Conference League is a very young competition, its format will be boosted next season by a thrilling new league phase with 36 clubs. The new format will increase unpredictability as all teams vie for a place directly in the round of 16 or the knockout round playoffs. But until then, there is still unfinished business in this year's competition. An impressive 13 countries are represented in this draw, including former UEFA club competition winners, each bringing their contribution that is sure to give us mouth-watering clashes and more intriguing moments as we continue on the road to Athens. And to assist with today's draw is a Greek football legend who had a long and prolific career for both the club and country.
And please welcome Kostas Katsouranis. Welcome, Kostas. Great to see you here in Lyon. Of course, you're going to be helping Giorgio with the draw very shortly. I did want to ask you a couple of questions. First of all, about the competition, the Conference League. It's been growing from strength to strength. So many exciting matches, as Giorgio mentioned, just in the last round. What's been most impressive for you, whether it's matches, clubs?
First of all, thank you for having me here. Good luck for all the teams. I hope one Greek team at least to the final. It's normal. It's only 16 teams.
Tell me how people are looking forward to this final in Greece and in Athens. A lot of excitement, I'm sure, right?
All the Athens wait this final in one new and very good stadium. And for Greece, it's an honor to have one final in Athens.
No doubt you had such an illustrious career, 20 years as a professional. Of course, you won Euro 2004. When you look at the magic of UEFA competitions overall, what does it make you feel as a player?
To play to this competition, you know, UEFA, Europa League, in Conference or in Champions League, for all the players is something special. The emotion is very high. And many countries, Greek play with Spain, with England. This for me is fantastic. You go in all this fantastic stadium, and for all the players, the emotion is very in the top.
Yeah, and it's a great point because we've got actually 13 countries, right, Giorgio, represented here in the draw today. Okay, we're nearly ready to go, but before, we need to invite on stage Tobias Hedstuk, who's the head of club competitions. He'll explain the technical procedure as well. Toby, welcome.
Thank you, Pedro, and of course, good afternoon, everyone, also from my side. Allow me directly to start to explain you the procedure for today's draw. Every group winner will be drawn against the winner of the knockout round playoffs from a different association. The group winners are seeded and play the second leg at home, whereas the winners of the knockout round playoffs play the first leg at home. Each of the eight pairings will be determined by drawing one of the winners of the knockout round playoffs first and then one of the eligible group winners. The eight balls containing the names of the knockout round playoffs winners are all placed in one ball, while the balls containing the names of their potential opponents are picked from the eight different group winners' bowls just in front of me. After drawing each knockout round playoffs winners, the computer will indicate which group winners can be drawn, bearing in mind that teams from the same country cannot play against each other. The relevant balls will be picked and placed into the other bowl, where one ball will be drawn to form a pairing with the knockout round playoffs winner already drawn. Should we have only one team eligible to be drawn against a particular knockout round playoffs winners, there will be no draw and the two teams will be paired directly. This procedure is then repeated for all the eight pairings. After the draw, and in accordance with the competition regulations, the UEFA administration will determine the final fixture list, which, due to the constellation of the teams, may involve reversals of fixtures. The calendar will be published today at 18 hours at the latest, and the fixture list is therefore not final until this announcement. Now, this is all the information you need to know, so let me hand the floor back to Giorgio so we can begin with the draw.
Exactly. Just one thing we can do before starting the draw. Let's recap the teams of this draw, starting with the seeded teams where we have LOSC Lille, Maccabi Tel Aviv FC, FC Victoria Pilsen, Club Bruges, Aston Villa FC, HF Fiorentina, PAOK FC and Fenerbahce SK. And among the unseeded teams, winners of the knockout round playoffs, we have SK Sturm Graz, Maccabi Haifa FC, GNK Dynamo, AFC Ajax, Molde FK, Olympiakos FC, Royal Union Saint-Gilloise and Servette FC. This is all, Kostas. I prepare the balls for you. And go ahead. Let's start the draw. And let's see who will play who in this emotional round of 16.
Servette.
So, first team drone doesn't come from very far away from here. It's Servette FC from Geneva. Eight teams are possible for them. All the eight group winners can be drawn against Servette, who had the best performance in a UEFA club competition, who had their best performance since 2001 and 2002 this season in a UEFA club competition. So, to play against Servette in a second, we see
Victoria Pilsen.
And that will be FC Victoria Pilsen, the only team which has won all the six matches in the group stage, and also the best defense with only one goal conceded, which means that the job for Servette will not be easy at all. And after Servette versus Victoria Pilsen, we are ready to see the match number two, starting with this team.
Ajax.
AFC Ajax, one of the most decorated European clubs. Ajax can play against all the seven remaining teams. Four-time winners of the Champions Cup, Champions League. Also winners of the UEFA Cup in 92. And the third appearance in the UEFA competition round of 16 in the last four seasons for Ajax.
Aston Villa.
So Ajax will take on Aston Villa FC from England at the first appearance in the knockout phase of a UEFA competition since 2009. Unbeaten in the last Conference League matches, the last five Conference League matches. Aston Villa also won the Champions Cup in 82. And for match number three, we start with Molde FK. Back from their victorious mission in Poland yesterday, Molde. Only once they appeared in the round of 16 in 2020-21. All the six opponents are possible for Molde.
Bruges.
Molde will play Club Brugge. Champions League round of 16 and last season for Brugge. So Molde Brugge is pairing number three, and we proceed with pairing number four.
Union Saint-Gilloise.
Now, Union Saint-Gilloise, the second successive season in a UEFA competition round of 16. Quarterfinals of Europa League last season. Five possible opponents, all remaining teams are possible. We don't have a country clash with Union Saint-Gilloise. Spruge has already been drawn.
Fenerbahce.
And the opponents of Union Saint-Gilloise is Fenerbahce from Istanbul. Second knockout phase of this competition in three seasons for Fenerbahce. They won 11 of their last 12 matches played at home. Pairing number five.
Dinamo Zagreb.
This time it is GNK Dinamo, and for Dinamo Zagreb we can draw with no condition all the four remaining teams in the pot of the group winners.
Slavia
So GNK Dinamo will take on this club.
PAOK.
PAOK. So Dinamo Zagreb versus PAOK Thessaloniki. This is pairing number 5. For PAOK, we had quarterfinals in the very first edition of the UEFA Conference League in 2022. PAOK is unbeaten in the last 13 UEFA Conference League matches, including qualifying rounds, of course.
Sturm Graz.
And we go with Sturm Graz from Austria. Now three clubs can be drawn against Sturm Graz, who played the quarterfinals of the UEFA Cup in 84. And even earlier, they played the quarterfinals of the Cup Winners' Cup in 76.
Lille.
And we have now Lille, LOSC Lille, facing Sturm Graz in this round of 16. So second appearance in the round of 16 for Lille in the last three seasons. They are still unbeaten in the Conference League matches of this season.
Maccabi Haifa.
And we have now Maccabi Haifa, which means that we have no draw possibilities, as the other team is Maccabi Tel Aviv. So Maccabi Haifa is paired automatically with Fiorentina. Maccabi Haifa Fiorentina is the last, second last pairing, and only one is left to be discovered. Let's see the name of the first team.
Olympiakos.
That's obviously Olympiakos FC, and for Olympiakos FC, the opponents in round of 16 will be Maccabi Tel Aviv. Thank you, Kostas. This is all for this draw.
It is indeed. Well done, gentlemen. A lot of excitement here in the room, no doubt about that, as 16 teams from 13 countries were drawn. Let's have a look at the result. Servette taking on Victoria Pilsen, Ajax facing Aston Villa, Molde playing Club Brugge, Union Saint-Gilloise taking on Fenerbahce, it's Dinamo against PAOK, Sturm Graz facing LOSC Lille, Maccabi Haifa playing Fiorentina, and Olympiakos taking on Maccabi Tel Aviv. Now, the first legs of the round of 16 are scheduled to be played on the 7th of March, and the second legs will be played on the 14th. The next and final draw of this season's competition will take place here in Lyon on the 15th. Of March. Now, one more note from our side before we go. As Giorgio mentioned earlier, next season UEFA men's club competitions evolve into a new dynamic 36-team league phase format where every match counts. Here are more details on what we can expect.
The 2024-25 season sees the start of an exciting new era for the UEFA Champions League, UEFA Europa League and UEFA Conference League. Taking part in the competitions, though, remains open and based on sporting merit. From next season, the current 32-team group stage will be replaced by a league phase featuring 36 teams in each of UEFA's three men's club competitions. Each team will be drawn against 8 different opponents, 2 from each of the 4 seeding pots, playing 4 at home and 4 away. However, in the UEFA Conference League, each team plays only 6 opponents, 1 from each of the 6 seeding pots. Teams that finish in positions 1-8 qualify directly for the round of 16. Teams ranked 9-24 must face each other in the knockout playoff round to join the top 8 in the round of 16. Teams in positions 25-36 are eliminated from all competitions. In the knockout phase, all ties are contested home and away, culminating with a single leg final. In the new league format, every match, every goal, every point and position in the ranking counts. The new system will ensure fast changing and unpredictable standings. More matches between equally ranked teams competing for crucial points, with fans able to enjoy top clashes right from the first match day. 2024, a thrilling new future for European club football.
We're all really looking forward to it from next season. Of course, so much more to be played in the current campaign, and we've just seen the draw results for the next stage of this competition. That'll do it from all of us here in Nyon, from Kostas, Giorgio and Toby and myself. It's goodbye. See you again soon. Take care.